Rest the graph 4y minus 6x equals 24 using the x and y intercepts. The point where a line crosses the x-axis or horizontal axis is called the x-intercept or horizontal intercept. Looking at the graph of the line y minus x equals 2 shown here below, notice how it intersects or crosses the horizontal or x-axis at the point negative 2 comma 0. Negative 2 comma 0 is the x-intercept or horizontal intercept. In general, to determine the x-intercept or horizontal intercept, we set y equal to 0 and solve for x. This should make sense because notice how any point on the x-axis or horizontal axis would have a y-coordinate of 0. The y-intercept or vertical intercept is the point where the line crosses the y-axis or vertical axis. Notice how the line intersects or crosses the vertical or y-axis at the point 0, 2. 0, 2 is the y-intercept or vertical intercept. In general, to determine the y-intercept or vertical intercept, we set x equal to 0 and solve for y. Again, this should make sense because any point on the y-axis or vertical axis has an x-coordinate of 0. Going back to our example, another way to find the intercepts would be to complete this special table of values, where for one row, y is equal to 0, for the second row, x is equal to 0. So let's begin by completing this first row, which will give us the x-intercept. Remember, in general, to determine the x-intercept, we set y equal to 0. So if we set y equal to 0 in our equation, we would have 4 times 0 minus 6x equals 24. Simplifying, this would be 0, so we have negative 6x equals 24. Divide both sides by negative 6. Simplifying, we have x equals 24 divided by negative 6 equals negative 4, which gives us the x-intercept or horizontal intercept, negative 4 comma 0. Let's go ahead and plot this point on the x-axis, which would be this point here. And now let's find the y-intercept by completing the second row in the table. So to find the y-intercept, we set x equal to 0 and solve for y. If we set x equal to 0, we have 4y minus 6 times 0 equals 24. Simplifying, we have 4y equals 24. Divide both sides by 4. We have y equals 6, which means the vertical intercept or y-intercept is 0 comma 6. Let's go ahead and plot the point 0 comma 6, which would be here. Now that we have the intercepts, we can graph the line. This is the line 4y minus 6x equals 24. Let's look at a second example. Here we're asked to graph the equation y equals negative 2x plus 3, again using the intercepts. So we'll first find the x-intercept by completing this first row of the table, or setting y equal to 0. So if we set y equal to 0, we would have 0 equals negative 2x plus 3. Let's isolate the x term by adding 2x to both sides, which would give us 2x equals 3, and then we'll divide both sides by 2. X equals 3 halves, which means the x-intercept or horizontal intercept is 3 halves comma 0. Let's go ahead and plot this point on the x-axis. 3 halves is the same as 1.5, which would be here. And now I'll complete the second row in order to determine the y-intercept or vertical intercept. So we'd have y equals negative 2 times 0 plus 3, so y equals 3, which means the vertical or y-intercept is 0 comma 3. Let's go ahead and plot the y-intercept, which would be this point here. Now that we have the intercepts, we can graph the line. This is the graph of y equals negative 2x plus 3. I hope you found this helpful.